Keeping the puck in safe areas. Kovalev back to Gonchar. Saved by Thomas. Spin around Spezza, and Thomas does the Chinese split.
Oh, Tim Thomas.
The white wizard.
We're not worthy. We're not worthy. We're not worthy.
Welcome to Tuca Time's post-game recap.
For the first time since 1937-1938, a Boston Bruins starter has started 6-0-0. Back then, it was Tiny Thompson. Today, Timmy the Tank, the White Wizard, Thomas. And get this, an absolutely mind-blowing 9.84 save percentage and a .50 goals against average. Wow. Oh, and you know, just 3 goals in 6 games. One of which he obviously just let in because he felt bad for the Capitals. So if you're claiming that you thought Thomas was going to start off like this, well, I would like to meet you in person and shake your hand because there is no way anybody on the face of this planet saw this coming. Now tonight, the Bruins take on the Northeast Division rivals, the Ottawa Senators, and they get the big win up there, 4-0. And 4:32 into the first period, the Bruins really get things going. The number one line, Lucic on the forecheck, he messes with Chris Phillips. Phillips fumbles the puck in the slot, Krejci picks it up, blasts it past Elliott, second of the season for Krejci, Bruins go up 1-0. So now the period's running down, couple chances for the Sens, but the Bruins had a pretty strong opening period on the road here. About 2:30 left, Wheeler gets a great chance on the net, doesn't capitalize, whistle blows, and who comes around the net and takes advantage of the punching bag known as Blake Wheeler to all Bruins fans out there? Matt Carkner, pop, but somehow Wheeler gets a slashing goal here and the Sens go on the power play. But no reason to fear because the Bruins make it 13 straight penalties killed and we head into the second period up 1-0. And about 8 minutes down the line, Daniel Alfred, no, goals cease to exist when the White Wizard, Thomas the White, is in net.
You shall not pass!
And this goal gets instantly waved off because Mike Fisher was in the crease. Score remains 1-0 Bruins. 5 minutes later, at the faceoff, Marchand gets tripped. Bruins go on their second power play of the night. Recchi gets it about halfway through. He's streaking down the left wing off a pass from Seidenberg. Sagan is cruising through the slot. Recchi slides it over. Sagan taps it home. Third of the year for Sagan. Man, what a goal. Bruins go up 2-0.
Recchi goes out to the left as Dennis Seidenberg carries the puck up ice. Recchi has a little bit of space on Carkner's side for Sagan. He scores! Tyler Sagan, a power play goal. The Bruins are up by 2.
And at 4:36, Horton goes to the box for tripping, but it proved to be great for the Bruins. They kill off yet another penalty. Horton come out of the box, breakaway for him. Elliott stones him, Sens go back the other way, but the Bruins get the puck back. Krejci in the neutral zone gets a streaking Lucic, sends him on the breakaway, and Lucic puts his first of the year through Elliott's five hole. Bruins go up 3-0, and we head to the third period. And really nothing too eventful here until about midway through when Patrice Bergeron knocks down the puck in his own zone. He feeds a streaking Jordan Caron in the neutral zone, sends him on the breakaway, and he beats Elliott for his third of the year, putting the Bruins up 4-0 for good, beating the Ottawa Senators to the tune of ole, ole, ole. I don't know. Third period, there was a lot of ole chants. I thought I was at like a freaking Canadiens game. I don't know what was going on. Someone want to explain that to me? I hear it was like Habs fans that started it, and then Sens fans carried it on. I also heard there was some rogue Bruins fans that started it for some reason. I have no idea what happened. Anybody that was at the game care to explain this to me? So here's my 3 stars for the night. Number 1, Tim Thomas, of course. Number 2, Tyler Sagan. Number 3, I am going to go with Patrice Bergeron tonight, ladies and gentlemen. Give me your 3 stars down below in the comments. I will see you Wednesday night when the Bruins take on the Buffalo Sabres. Don't forget to follow me on Twitter at TukaTime40. Take it easy, guys.